Now, tonight we have an 8 on your side special report. What do you do when your cell phone takes the plunge, shall we say? It's something many of you can relate to. You spend hundreds of dollars on that phone, and then it's all wet.
Tonight, News 8 on your side consumer reporter Brian Roach shows you how to save your cell.
It's a near tragedy that can happen to anyone. Telephones in toilets, or toppled into a fish tank. Whatever the case, you may be able to save your cell with a few simple steps. First of all, don't try to pull a fast one on your cell phone company and claim the phone just stopped working. Most cell phones come with a water sticker inside that permanently changes color if the phone gets wet. Once you get the phone out of the water, resist the urge to turn it on to see if it still works. Just turning it on when it's wet could short it out. But act fast, because the longer the water sits inside the phone, the more it could be damaged. First of all, remove the battery and the memory card. And if it's a flip phone, open it up and expose as much of the phone as possible to air. If you've got a powerful shop vacuum, hold the phone near the vacuum and try to suck out as much moisture as you can. Use the vacuum for at least 5 minutes, even if you see no water coming out of the phone. Then take a bowl of uncooked rice and leave the phone and the battery submerged in the bowl of rice overnight. The rice should soak up any additional moisture that's still inside the phone. Now, if you drop the phone in salt water, remove the battery quickly and rinse the phone in fresh water before starting the drying process. Salt water can do damage even after it dries. And here are some things you should not do. Do not use a hairdryer, oven, or microwave. The heat may get rid of the moisture, but it could also fry other parts of the phone. After you have waited at least 24 hours, make sure the phone is clean and dry and reattach the battery. If it doesn't turn on, try plugging it into its charger. If it turns on while plugged in, then you may need a new battery.
Now, we should point out that there's no guarantee that any of these steps are going to bring your cell phone back to life, but you really have nothing to lose by trying them. That's because with most cell phone companies, the warranties on the phone are void the second that your cell phone sinks. I'm Brian Roach on your side, News 8.
Now remember, you should wait at least 24 hours to try to turn on a phone that's been wet. If you can wait for 2 to 3 days, that could increase the chances of your phone coming back to life. Now for more tips on saving your cell phone, go to WGAL.com and look under Hot Links.